Thank you, Chairman Meeks. I don't recognize the CEP as legitimate to organize election. First of all, the way it was constituted, it doesn't reflect the constitution, and the people who were involved were not sent by key sectors of civil society in Haiti. It was then presented at the court, at the Supreme Court, like it was supposed to do. This is an illegal CEP, and there is no way the CEP could organize fair, credible elections.
Thank you. Madam Ambassador White, do you agree?
100%.
Now, let me ask also, what role do you believe the multilateral groups like Corp Group or Caricom and other interested parties in the international community should play in Haiti? And how can the United States best engage with our international partners so that we, the internet, are speaking with one voice, not divided? No, we can't be divided when it comes to Haiti. We've got to all speak with one voice and be clear about it.
Are you speaking to me still?
Yes.
Yes, thank you, Chairman. The core group is essential to come together and speak with one voice. You're absolutely right. The United States government has always been, if not the leading voice, certainly one of the leading voices on that core group, because no one gives more to Haiti than the United States of America in many, many ways, not just monetarily. But I think that the leadership we need to have at that core group meeting, we need to have a clear view of how we are going to articulate our policy for the next 18 months at least. And I think your chair, your leadership can help them define how to move forward. Because as I said in my statement, we need to have clear lines in the sand. If this doesn't happen, the money stops. We need to look at what our policies are going to be. I was reading about the UN and the US and the OAS all saying that they support Moise to stay for another year, but I didn't hear what the conditionality for that was. And I'd like to hear that articulated.
Thank you.